Welcome to our channel, The Child. Today we are going to talk about another arithmetic activity. This is based on multiplication. Many children are finding difficult to memorize the results of basic combinations. For example, 5 multiplied by 3, 6 multiplied 5, like that, right? So we have something called multiplication full chart. Half chart is also available and a blank chart is also available. If you Google for Montessori multiplication full chart, multiplication half chart, multiplication blank chart, you will be getting many pictures. You can take a printout or you can draw. It's very simple, okay? You have to take a A4 sheet or chart paper and you can simply look at it and you can draw. Just make a draw a table based on the number of columns and rows, and you can write the basic combinations and results. It's very simple, I will show you. Before going to that, let's inform the child about each and everything, right from the etymology of the word multiplication. Okay, to make the child understand what is multiplication, I have given another video which you can refer in our channel. Story, multiplication story. Okay, so you can refer that and come back to this one. Okay, so using that video you can make the child understand what is multiplication, which is nothing but taking the same quantity and put them together several times is called multiplication. The same quantity, okay, it's not different quantity, same quantity, and we are taking them and putting them together, that is called multiplication. The word multiplication, it's a Latin word. Multi means many, which we are aware, which we are very much aware, and plico means I fold. Many times we would have heard the word multifolded. It folded many times, like that, right? So that is the etymology. And 5 multiplied by 3 is equal to 15. Introduce to the child, this is multiplicand, this is multiplier, and this is product. The importance of this is very important. Multiplier is the number of times this number is getting multiplied. Okay, this is the number of times. Multiplier is the number of times this multiplicand is getting multifolded. Okay, I repeat, multiplier is the number of times this number multiplicand is getting multiplied. So the resultant is called product. There are 81 basic combinations, but not necessary that we should memorize or we have to register in the mind of the child. Out of this 81 basic combinations, if we know 45 basic combinations, the child should be able to tell us any combination. Okay, before going to the material, also introduce to the child the difference between 5 multiplied by 3 and 3 multiplied by 5. Okay, consider this as lollipops. 5 lollipops have been taken one in a row and we have taken 3 times. First time we have taken 5 lollipops, second time again 5 lollipops, third time again 5 lollipops. So the same quantity, the same quantity which we have taken several times is 5, and we have taken 3 times. So the multiplicand 5 is taken 3 times and the answer is 15. Here 3 multiplied by 5 is 15. We have taken only 3 lollipops at a time. Okay, and how many times we have taken? 5 times. So even though the answer is same, there is a huge difference between 5 multiplied by 3 and 3 multiplied by 5 when it comes to the quantity. Okay. And also you can always tell the child that 5 multiplied by 3 is 15, 3 multiplied by 5, the answer will be the same. It is multiplicand into multiplier or multiplicand into multiplier, the answer, the product will be the same. And some properties like any number multiplied by 0 is 0. So like that, if you can tell the properties of multiplication, it will register in their mind and it will help them for problem solving and logicals, for their logical skills. Okay. Okay. With this information, I'll show you. See, there are so many types of multiplication charts. Okay. I have taken this one because of seeing this font. Okay, when you're taking the printout, make sure that the font size is very legible. Okay, so here actually you can see till 12 table, right? But in the original chart will have 10 to 10 bar 10 or till 9 only. So before going to this one, you can write like 6 taken 1 equal 6. Like that you can give prepared problems to the child, so that the child can write. Because whenever they are verbalizing and writing, it will register in their mind properly. Okay. Now, we'll ask the child, first invite the child and say, we are going to do multiplication chart today. And this is the problems which we are going to solve. Okay. Now, let's say, let's do 6 multiplied by 5. Okay. So, have 6, show 6 using your left index and 5 using your right index. So, 6 left index, 5 using your right index. So the square where they meet shows the result. So 6 multiplied by 5 is 30. So ask the child to write. Okay, let's do one more. 6 multiplied by 3. So 6 show 6 using your left index and 3 using right index. So the square where they meet is called, it shows the result. So 6 multiplied by 3 is 18. Right? So ask the child to, if you can prepare till 10, then the child will write. And also every time you are doing a multiplication, ask the child to verbalize it. 6 multiplied by 5 is 30. And also make the child to write. So, if you see any advertisement, okay, they are telecasting it every few seconds. The duration of an advertisement is few seconds, but they are advertising it multiple times, okay. So, they are registering their brand in our brains. So, like that, repetition is very valuable when it comes to Montessori environment. Make the child to repeat this activity daily. And there are other materials also with multiplication, which I will show you in different videos. And apart from this, I will show you some tricks. Okay, let them make use of the material. Let them work as many times as possible. And also, to memorize, okay, the combination, the results of the basic combinations, you can give something like this. 5 multiplied by 5. Okay, actually I am giving in my own way. You can find multiple ways, different ideas to help a child to tell the answer quickly. Ask the child how many fives they see. 2 fives. So ask them to write like this. And then 7 multiplied by 8. So tell the child that after 7, it's 8. Ask the child what comes before 7. 6. Before 6, it's 5. Okay, if you give like this, then over a period of time, it will become easy. And I will also give you a quick tip for 9 tables, okay? If it is just you need the 10 fingers, suppose it's 9 multiplied by 2. Ask the child to fold the finger in the second place. Now, 1. And if you count these fingers, it's 8. So the answer is 18. And also for 5 table, 9 multiplied by 5. Ask the child to fold the 5th finger. So here it's 4 and here it's 5. So 45 is the answer. From 9 multiplied by 7. So fold this finger in the 7th position. So the answer is this side. From this side, it is 6. And the other side, okay, 3. So the answer is 63. Okay, so 9 table, it's very easy. So if you find this video helpful to you, please share with your friends and please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.